Alrighty, so Games for Freedom Studios, we had Follows Finesse. It was Follows Liberation and Play tonight for our theme. And the whole idea of it was we started with the idea of giving the followers leg articulation and understanding puppet strings coming forwards and backwards to avoid any type of lifting up. Up would create a lot of marching, whereas the idea of if I pitch a little forward on the balls of my feet, chin, chest, balls of the feet, and I think of drawing forward, that's going to draw my leg forward and then you can walk. And then I just go all three joints, straighten, boom, we're good to go, heel to toe. The thing I talked about is followers, especially in the sugar pushing app, you want to keep that back foot rooted and find out your natural turnout so you don't wobble. Right, so we talked about a little bit of degrees of open, and that's what we think walking one foot in front of the other. Try not to stop, because that's going to make you wobble too. You want to keep being pulled forward and being pulled backwards. And that's where we move from. But that kickstand foot is really important, because when you get into a sugar push or something, you don't want to gerbil your feet and scramble. You want to keep them connected to the floor, but know that they're different than the arms. They're separate than the body, so we're not pushing with our weight, we're absorbing a little in the arms. And that's the key. We talked about natural height in the elbows, and that's what keeps me in my natural frame. If I keep a nice set shoulder, everything's relaxed, basically I can only go this far, personally, in my own body. That's as much. So keep that in mind, really, really helpful. And then what we did was we did triple step drill. So I talked about Mario Rabal. Thank you, Mario. 9 points. Boom, boom, boom. Boom, boom, boom. We talked about keeping the same amount of turnout at the foot when we start and when we finish. So triple land, or one, two, one, two. Dragging more of the upbeats and taking the time to land. Right, middle of the beat. Boom, boom, boom. Swing timing. Then we talked about if we can do it in front, we can also do it behind. So I can do it opening the hips, or I can do it hips stay square and the foot crosses behind. We found out that if we go really tight with the footwork, it's very easy to be able to cross in front. If we go wider, we started using the acronym DYFS. Do you feel silly? Do you feel stable? Do you feel stupid? So if you're going like this and you feel silly, check yourself before you wreck. Alright? So the idea is stay ergonomic to your body and allow your body to naturally twist, counter. Twist in the shirt equals contra body motion instead of this way. Right? And that's going to keep me from going on diagonal. Versus what I'm actually doing is moving sideways and then a slight diagonal. It's very subtle. Boom, boom, boom. So keep it tight and light. And then the idea was we took this and put it in a couple basic patterns. So we had sugar brush, 1, 2, 3, and 4. We create the angle just like I had you in the hips. And we want to practice this, if we're without a partner, with our arms up like we're in a bit of a frame, right? So our steering wheel is up. So then we can learn to dance within that, not outside of that. You can see the break in the arms. Keep it on the outside of your body. And so we can cross in front and then hit our anchor on the way back. So walk, walk, to triple step. Obviously an angle, triple step. To do the second variation, what we do is 1, 2, 3, and we shoot off a little bit more on the diagonal, which allows us to draw the left foot behind, crossing in front, and step. Don't think about the feet, ladies, think about your core. So watch your center, rotate into the shoulder, and then it opens 5 and 6. Whatever you can play with, we're really exploring bending the slot and coming back to the middle. And oh, and we can also do it in the middle segment of our bases. So we could do it here, and then we could do it here. So if I did an underarm turn, maybe I try and explore, boop, doom, doom, and then I turn around for 5 and 6. find my anchor. We're 1, 2, and I decide to go 3, 4, 5, and 6. Just a couple variations for you. And the other thing we did was take that same sugar push, we use the angle, and we're going to go in towards our body. You create a body wave and then triple. So we're not doing a triple step, but we're doing a triple ripple. So we're going womp, womp, triple step, triple back. And I talked about keeping this really loose and kind of basically dancing in your own arm or hand and then away from your own hand. So you're stretching and finding tension. You're not feeding your arm and trying to move your partner. It will be so much easier if you practice with the doorknob or your partner, right? Because you want to feel tension and then learn to isolate and then roll it back. Bonus is you can get all the way back into your anchor, free up the foot, and then go. And pretty much talked about that. Anytime you guys are doing drills, make sure you look ahead so you don't do things in your shoulders that you don't want to do. Right? If I'm looking forward at my partner or past my partner, I'm looking ahead with my gaze, my body tends to do things naturally. And it will really improve your dance. We talked about 4 being the magic count. So when we land here, we got to be on our weight so then we can go in any direction. We can side and together, side and back, or cross in front. I couldn't do that if I wasn't on my foot. Cool? Great job, ladies. DanceForFreedom.com. Classes start September 4th. Pre-register so you save money. Ciao. Great job.
Thank you.